Hello.
Thank you.
Yes, goodbye.
Mister, if I'm dreaming, don't wake me up.
You just got nominated for an Academy Award.
The series had to end at the Academy Awards because for our characters to be fully seen, it would be at the Oscars. It's kind of the place where the inner circle and the rest of the world connects.
Hollywood, California. Tinseltown is boomtown.
Action! One of the beautiful things about this show and shooting in Los Angeles is that there's a feeling of it all happened here. The thing that Ryan talked a lot about was scale and scope and grandeur. And it's like, if you're going to shoot the Oscars, let's get that feeling of being sort of swept in it. So a lot of like sweeping moves and really feeling the bigness of it.
It's the 20th Academy Awards in Hollywood, California.
Outside the Shrine Auditorium, most of the work there was practical. We had a ton of amazing lights and a ton of talent and a ton of cars. And it was just a small amount of cleanup.
Jack Costello, first-time nominee for Best Supporting Actor.
The red carpet, I loved that sequence. It's the public presentation of Hollywood and then the private reality of what it's like to experience it from the inside.
It's magic.
It takes us into the world of the newsreel. It's how the public sees it. Oh, isn't so glamorous? There's one movie star, there's another movie star. Look who's coming down the red carpet. And then when it gets to Rock and Archie.
And whose hand is he holding? Why, it's not a she, but a he.
Boom, we cut to what that feels like. That nice hard cut from newsreel, fixed camera, black and white, to color. It was meant to be jarring, that we are in the public eye, and now we're in the private moment. They're getting booed, photographers are turning their backs.
Are we doing the right thing?
Absolutely we are.
The theater was packed with all of our beautifully dressed background actors. And then downstairs, we had the green room area. So between those two locations, we had seven cameras. Sometimes it was seven cameras in the theater. Sometimes it was two downstairs, five upstairs. And so there really was a feeling of like, oh, now we're shooting the Oscars.
Here we go.
The real chunk of work that happened was creating all the crowds, creating the film industry of the 40s coming together inside the theater. The theater needed to look appropriate, the theater needed to look clean, the theater needed to look beautiful, and every single seat in that theater had to be filled.
That's more like
it. I think the thing that I love about the finale is how emotional it is, and I wanted each award to feel different. I wanted our characters' experiences to feel different. The last thing you want is to feel that you're at an actual award ceremony and having to sit through speech after speech from the same perspective. This needed to be an emotional experience. And so I was really pleased with how that worked out. It is something that really matters to each of these characters.
Anna Mae Wong, come back!
With Anna Mae Wong, there is a feeling of a dream that she thought was gone already coming back to her. There's personal history to that moment that resonates and is very powerful.
You gave my life purpose again. Thank you.
When Archie wins, I think that there's a freedom to his win that really takes over that moment. You feel like there's a personal liberation, like this is the moment where he's fully him. With Raymond winning for Best Director, this is joyful and it's fun. That was really important, that for him, yes, it's emotional, but in the scope of everyone's wins, it's almost like icing on the cake.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner is Camille Washington.
And then when Camille wins, I think she's the storyteller there. There's a little sequence where her name is announced and the moment kind of freezes. Everything's sort of in slow motion. It's sort of muffled and it's like she can't attach the reality of it. Can this really be happening? And then when she gets up there and she holds the statue, it's like there's this part of her that snaps into place and says, no, you do belong here.
Thank you all so much.
She is poised and she's owning the moment and she's not having to grovel for it in any way.
I kept waiting to see someone show up on screen who looked like me. Thank you to the Academy for making sure that no little girl staring up at that screen will ever again be told that there are limits to what she can achieve.
And then with Avis.
And the winner
for Best Motion Picture is...
You don't actually see Avis when you see her tension. Like, did she do this? Did she pull it off? Are they going to accept her in this position of authority? And then there she is, flanked by her other Oscar winners, and she's bringing it home. A show like this is part of that theme of people need to be working together. It's not enough for one person to just say, I'm going to do this, because you need a village. That's pretty powerful.